Hey everyone, Matt here from SoundSwitch, and in this tutorial video, we're going to be showing you through the project settings, as well as the preferences that are new in SoundSwitch 2.3. So let's get into it. In this tutorial video, we're going to be showing you through the SoundSwitch project workflow. This is new in SoundSwitch 2.3. We'll also be showing you through some of the preferences and explaining how these work and affect your light shows. Let's start with the SoundSwitch projects. Previously, all of your SoundSwitch data was stored in one SoundSwitch folder. Now, you can split all of your SoundSwitch information up into different SoundSwitch projects. Let me show you what I mean. Over in edit mode, if you select to open the file menu, you can see that there is now new projects, open an existing project, save project, as well as save project as and export project. If you would like to create a new project, simply select for a new project, type in the name of your project, Matt's new project, and click save. Then you'll be presented with a blank workspace. If you would like to open a previous project, simply select Open Project. And here I can select my GigBar automation project. And all of my information will be there, including my venues, my auto loops, and all of my scripted tracks. If I would like to make a duplicate of this particular project, I can save a project as, and save it as GigBar Backup. Now, if I go back to open a project, I can see that I have both my GigBar automation test project and my GigBar backup. I'll go back to opening my automation test project. We also have an option for exporting a project. Here you can select to export just some of the venues that you have, or you can choose to export all of them. You can also choose to export or to not export the lighting tracks. This is helpful if you want to export your venue and share it with another user. For example, you might set up a GigBar move with a number of attributes, auto loops, and position cues. You could then export just the venue while not exporting your lighting files. In the Generals tab, we have added a 4-player plus mixer option for Engine OS DJs who are using 4 players in a mixer rather than just 2 players. And for virtual DJ users, we have removed the connect on this computer setting and just replaced it with auto connect. Under the library section, you can see that we've removed the ability to select which SoundSwitch folder you're using, as this is now handled in the project workflow. Under performance mode, we've also added the option to activate or deactivate faders. This is helpful if you're using one of the channels on your mixer as an input from a secondary device, such as an iPad or other audio source. This allows you to ignore that fader so that the light show won't be affected by the positions of that channel fader. In the hardware tab, we have added the ability to enable and disable Philips Hue, as well as connect to Philips Hue bridges. Here we can see our different lighting setup, as well as our different entertainment areas. These settings are covered off in the Philips Hue video, which is linked in the description below. So that's how you can use the new project workflow to organize your SoundSwitch data. If you have any questions about SoundSwitch projects or any of the changes to the preferences, please leave a comment in the comment section below or reach out to support@soundswitch.com. You can also join the user group on Facebook or send us a message on Instagram Messenger or Facebook Messenger. Thanks, and we'll see you in another video.